Why, if I criticize Hinduism, am I not accused of Hindophobia? Why, if I criticize liberalism, I'm not accused of liberophobia, but if I criticize Islam, I am accused of Islamophobia.
You are a liar about Islam.
Yes.
A British court in
I explained it to him, and then he said that there were anti-Muslim pogroms in Europe.
Yes, I have.
And then I asked him for evidence, and he gave none.
Yeah, I gave nothing.
So, nothing. So, an anti-Christian pogrom, for those of you that don't understand the term like this, brother, is something that happens quite a lot in places like Egypt and Pakistan, where Muslim mobs go into Christian areas, burn down Christian churches, attack Christian families in their homes, and what needs to happen is that the church needs to recognize the strategical importance of Speaker's Corner and organize its evangelists and its missionaries to be here in teams. Ali Dawa, I think, was scared because there's too many people around to debate something that is so publicly embarrassing as the slavery that Muhammad practiced and permitted.
And why does the God debate only people that it seems to be debating are the only people that don't know much about Islam?
Well, the Islamic Dawa team here at the corner deliberately target people who are cultural Christians, who in an emotional spat will say, I'm a Christian, and then try to defend it. And these are people that have probably never darkened the door of the church or have never picked up their Bible recently or studied it. And the reason why they do that is because they're very easy prey. They're very easy prey to the Islamic Dawah team to target cultural...
They seem to be desperate. Oh, the whole Ali Dawah team, they seem to be desperate to debate Christians. But for example, when it comes to debating like Christian Prince, I've seen that none of them seems to try and debate him.
Well, I think
because he speaks Arabic, he understands.
I would actually correct you and say that the Islamic Dawah team is effective. The Islamic Dawah team are targeting weak Christians and cultural Christians. Tourists who are coming to the corner and don't know anything about their faith and have been more influenced by liberal society than they have by the teachings of the church. And when they are challenged,
when they are challenged
by Christians who know something of their religion and know something of their own, they run away from those debates. But when they want to meet a cultural Christian, they find it very easy to overpower them intellectually. And so actually they're very effective. And what needs to happen is that the church needs to recognize the strategical importance of Speaker's Corner and organize its evangelists and its missionaries to be here in teams with cameras, trained in apologetics, trained in polemics, and having a muscular faith, a clear sense of their own identity, to witness to these crowds that you see around us, many of whom will say, I'm a Christian. But then when asked a difficult question, we'll not be able to give any kind of answer. So I would challenge you actually and say, it's not desperation on their part, it's intelligence. They're really quite clever.
No, they're clever in what they do, but they don't really, they pick and choose and who they debate. This
absolutely
is my point.
Absolutely.
You see, Ali Dawah just ran away from debating you, and he saw an English guy, and he thought, yeah, maybe this guy doesn't know much about Islam, I haven't seen him here before. So he just picked him in a corner where he thinks he can brainwash him.
It is exactly what they do. And too many people come here because their opinions and views are formed by liberal society. That's all right, I'll deal with that. They're formed by liberal society, and they come here conditioned because we have what is called Islamophilia in this country. the state suppresses any critique of Islam. People lose their jobs for critiquing Islam.
Do we have Islamophobia, yes or no?
Not because they've critiqued Muslims, but because they have critiqued Islam. Now, that kind of enforced Islamophilia is subjecting the mind of the people, forming the mind of the people, to have no ability to form a reasoned response or critique of Islam, which is what groups like DCCI and Fanda Films, Dunder J. Smith, and myself and Sokol Films are doing, as well as advocating the Christian alternative. Now, is there one final question from you, and then I'm going to take on the guy?
You can speak to the guy.
What time are we on, Jason?
Yes, sir.
Let's ask the scholar.
Okay, so I got about 40 minutes and then I have to go.
I ask a question. Is there Islamophobia in Europe and England, yes or no?
By this question...
What is Islamophobia?
No, let me answer the question. So the question is there Islamophobia? Yes, there is Islamophobia, like there is Christophobia, Commiphobia, Hindophobia, Buddhophobia, Freedophobia. Now, the thing is, there are prejudices of every kind in our society. Why does Islamophobia get special recognition?
No, you haven't said about it in this case.
I answered your question directly. I said yes.
Islamophilia.
I said yes.
You no. have been spoken no, about Islamophilia. Yes,
hold on
no?
1 second. Hold on 1 second.
Bob, you are.
Why does Islamophobia,
Islamophilia
have special
what
recognition
is Islamophilia?
In our
are we above the law in this country?
Why does Islamophobia have special
yes
recognition?
Or no?
If I criticize communism, if I criticize Hinduism, if I criticize... Brother,
let him talk,
Okay, right. So I'll let those two talk, I'll finish the point that I
want. No, run away,
okay.
I need you here.
No, so why if I criticize Hinduism, am I not accused of Hindophobia? Why if I criticize liberalism, I'm not accused of liberophobia, but if I criticize Islam, I am accused of Islamophobia.
You are a liar about Islam.
Now, let me ask you a question. I answered your question directly. I am going to ask you one question. Do you believe that there is Christophobia in the Islamic world?
We cannot talk at the same time.
So, answer my question. I've answered your question directly. Everyone heard me do it. Do you believe?
Do you believe? Did you hear what he said?
Do you believe? I'm going to repeat the question. I'm going to repeat the question. Do you believe that there is Christophobia in the Islamic world?
Answer.
Sometimes yes.
Okay. Fine.
Yes. I'm sometimes.
When there's anti-Christian pogroms in Egypt. Such as when there's anti-Christian pogroms in Pakistan.
Is there crimes done against Muslims here? I said in the Muslim world, yes, there is. Now, is there crimes? Mosques being burned. In Europe, does this happen? Is
women
there Islamophobia and crimes against Muslims? Does this happen, yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Now, answer me this question. Answer me this question. Have there been...
Question for question, okay?
My question... Yes, question
yes.
for question.
Okay.
Have there been anti-Christian pogroms in Pakistan and Egypt?
What is anti-Christian pogroms?
So, an anti-Christian pogrom, for those of you that don't understand the term like this, brother... is something that happens quite a lot in places like Egypt and Pakistan, where Muslim mobs go into Christian areas, burn down Christian churches, attack Christian families in their homes, attack Christian property, Christian shops, Christian businesses.
I think I've buzzed the question.
So, I'm going to ask
we
you again, now that I've explained it, now that I've explained it, now that I've explained it, are there anti-Christian pogroms in places like Egypt and Pakistan?
I'm not going to say it is Islamic pogroms.
So, do you notice, ladies and gentlemen, his equivocation in speaking out against injustice?
Now,
do you notice his equivocation?
If you're going to use the word pogrom, I don't know what's pogrom.
I've explained it to you.
Then there is pogrom against Muslims as well.
Now,
yeah.
When was the last anti-Muslim pogrom in Europe?
I want to ask you, are we above the law here or not?
No,
yeah.
No.
As Muslims?
No.
Do you think we
are? I've answered your question, question for question.
Yes.
Question for question. Notice two things. One, When asked to acknowledge the anti-Christian pogroms in Egypt and Pakistan that are well documented and well known, he equivocated.
On a weekly basis.
He did not want to admit to it.
I'm Egyptian, by the way. Yeah.
That's the first point. The second point.
Yesterday,
the second point, he attempted. Shut up a second, shut up, brother. You wanted a question for question.
How much freedom okay. we need for the Christians?
So, he equivocated on the question of Islamic pogroms against Christians.
I think he cannot confirm.
Now, he also tried to justify that by talking about anti-Muslim pogroms in Europe. So now I want you to give me the evidence of the last anti-Muslim riot in Europe, please.
Where's the evidence?
Evidence.
Evidence.
Show us.
Let him drink the coffee.
As go on, evidence. There, mosques burned in Europe.
That's not an anti-Christian pogrom.
Muslims.
That's not an anti-Muslim pogrom. It's a crime, but it's not a pogrom.
To burn a mosque.
It's not a pogrom.
What happened to Jeddah?
It's not a pogrom.
Tell me, my friend, what happened to Jeddah?
So,
what happened to
Jeddah?
No,
stop touching me. Stop touching
me. You have to answer.
Stop
okay.
touching
me.
So,
don't get violent.
Stop touching me.
We don't need your violence up here now.
Let's be clear.
What happened to Jeddah, for sons?
Stop touching
me. Do you notice?
What happened to
Jeddah? Ladies and gentlemen,
Jeddah attacking Muslim homes. Answer now.
Apologies.
I need you to answer now.
Stated that he did not know what a pogrom was.
A British court in Folkestone.
I explained it to him.
Jeddah.
And then he said that there were anti-Muslim pogroms in Europe.
Yes, I have.
And then I asked him for evidence, and he gave none.
Yeah, exactly. Nothing.
So, nothing.
I'm Bretton Forest.
I ask all of you to get onto
Google.
Answer me.
And to type in
what happened to Bretton Forest leaders
of Christians in Egypt and Pakistan.
Answer now.
And
answer.
You will see examples of anti-Christian pogroms.
What happened to Bretton Forest?
By Muslim mobs against
Christians. Can you answer?
No.
You cannot answer.
This kind of prejudice.
Bretton
Forest. When was the last time that any of you heard of the anti-Christian pogroms in Egypt or Pakistan?
Leaders are in prison.
Hold up.
They support my claim.
Pakistan and Egypt. We'll leave it there. Yeah. We'll leave it there.
Purpose in a historical process that the church is doing as it moves through time, which is establishing the kingdom of God here on earth. Now, let me ask you, brother. I mean, are you a Christian?
Yes.
You are a Christian?
Yeah.
As in, you practice the Christian faith?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
You go to church?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're part of a fellowship?
I visit churches. I don't really.
Okay, that's fair enough. All Christians at some point go through that problem, that point. But I would encourage you to go deeper, to ingrain that within your soul more, so that you can become a man in every sense, fortified on all sides.
Yeah.
That you can be courageous when the time demands, that you can be humble when the time demands, that you can be generous when the time demands, that you can be prudent when the time demands. Study your faith. Preach your faith. Give charitably. Live in community with other Christians.
Yeah.
Practice the prayer of solitude. I'm trying to think of the seven disciplines. There's two more, they'll come to me.
You had enough to think about today.
Well, I've given you five. The other two will probably come to me when you walk away. But take these things and through discipline, form your life into the image of Christ. Yeah?
Yeah.
Don't be put off by the effeminization of the traditional churches. If we make Mother Church strong, Mother Church will make us strong. If we allow Church to be oppressed by her enemies, then the church will make us weak. And right now, many bishops have sold their offices to the service of the state, rather than seeing their office as being an opportunity to serve the church.
What do you mean, man?
They're serving the wrong people. You're saying, what do I mean? It's a fair
question. No, I'm not talking to you.
Talk to my brother.
Okay. Anyway, I'll leave you with those thoughts, brother.
Bless
peace of the Lord be with you.
Yeah,
you too.